when you start dairy farming, it doesn't take you very long to realize that the cows are the boss. Their needs have to come first, what their demands are. They might not be able to say it out loud, but they can let you know what's going on. And you work for the cows on a dairy farm. They don't work for you.
If we look at what's happening in the agriculture world today, there are a lot of silos of innovation that are happening at a very rapid pace.
Agriculture is undergoing an evolution, and technology is becoming an essential part of that.
My name is Tom Trantham. My family owns and operates Happy Cow Creamery. We started bottling and processing our own milk here on the farm with Happy Cow Creamery in 2002.
The partnership with Happy Cow Creamery began in 2018. Happy Cow wanted to produce better quality dairy products.
We have to make sure that we provide higher quality products than you can get in the grocery store right down the street from you, because when you're going to make the trip out to Happy Cow, we got to make sure that it's worth it. Before the partnership with Hitachi, we really didn't have any type of monitoring with our coolers and freezers. If something happened in the middle of the night or on a Sunday when the store was closed and you walk in Monday morning and you look at the freezer and everything's thawed, ice cream's melted, and you've got $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 worth of product sitting there that's ruined. If we have a huge storm and a lot of rain, we can be alerted to the fact that, hey, the lagoon is getting to a high point where it needs to be pumped down.
It's a full cycle. If you can digitize and monitor all the environmental factors that go into producing dairy farms and dairy cows and the milk they produce, it enhances the farmer's efficiency. It also produces better quality milk, and it actually gets to the table and produces better for the environment and better for the people.
Having the Hitachi systems in place really helps us prevent loss. It also allows you to see if there's a potential problem coming with a cooler or a freezer, because you can see irregularities in your temperatures. Having all that information from those sensors and then being able to just pull up my phone and access it through the Hitachi app, just all of it in one place right there to see everything from what my lagoon level is to do I need to order feed to is everything frozen or refrigerated the way it should be.
Those are digitization of items that can feed to the Internet of Living Things, where we can take all of that data, we can integrate the data, we can analyze the data and provide information to the farmer.
As a result of making use of digital technologies in the smart agriculture space, it is this ability to take sensor data, combine it with other data sources and model it that enables us to address these environmental risks related to lagoons overflowing or related to animal health related problems that can further affect the environment negatively.
When you're talking about agriculture, whether it be crops, cattle, dairy, anything that you do, you have to put back whatever you take out. When you milk that cow in the morning and you take 60 pounds of milk out of her, you got to give her something back to replace that. When you take a crop off of a field, that crop took from that soil and you've got to put it back in there. If you don't, you're not going to get the next crop. You always have to keep giving back